In this demonstration, I will show you how to use the DITA Reusable Components view in Oxygen XML Editor. This view is helpful for DITA documentation projects that utilize a large amount of keys and reusable components. This view is hidden by default, so if it is not displayed, it can be opened by selecting it from the Window Show View menu. The view includes two tabs, and it collects all the keys and reusable components that are defined in the routemap structure. Then, it presents them in a dynamic table where you can easily locate and insert references to them. First, I'll show you how to use the Keys tab. Notice that it has a tabular structure with columns that display the key names, their description, the href where the keys point to, and the location of the map file where the key is defined. The Keys tab displays all of your keys and provides ways to easily insert references to them as cross-reference links, key references, or variables. Another nice feature that helps you to see where the keys are defined is the ability to group them by definition location. To demonstrate how to use this tab, I'm using the Oxygen User's Manual project, which contains hundreds of key definitions. I have a topic opened where I've identified some content that needs to be replaced with keys, and I'm going to show you several different ways to insert them using this view. First off, I've noticed that the name of our product appears at the beginning of the first paragraph. I know I have a key defined for it, so I'll use the search filter to look for this particular key. Notice that the contextual menu includes a Go to Definition action that allows you to open the file where the key is defined and see that particular key definition. Now I'm going to replace the product name that is in plain text in my topic with the appropriate key using the Reusable Components view. One way to do this is to simply drag the key and drop it into my document. Note that if the selected key has the href value, it is inserted as a cross-reference link. If it's a reference to an image, it's inserted as an image element. Otherwise, it is inserted as a variable reference inside a phrase element. I'll briefly switch to the full tags mode just to show you that Oxygen inserts this particular key as a variable in a ph element, since our product key does not have an href value. Next, I've noticed that I have the word perspectives wrapped in a term element. I know that I have a glossary term for this word defined as a key, and in the output I want that term to be a link to that key reference. So, I select that whole term element, and now I just need to find that specific key in the Reusable Components view. In our documentation project, all keys that are created for glossary terms have the same naming convention. They begin with gloss entry, so I can simply search for gloss. As you can see, all our glossary terms are listed and sorted alphabetically. By the way, you can change the sorting of any of the columns in this tab simply by clicking on the column header. Now, I'll show you another method for inserting the key references, so I'll scroll down and locate my perspective glossary term. And I can simply double-click the key. In this case, since this particular key has an href value, notice that Oxygen inserted it as a cross-reference link inside an xref element. There's one more method you can use to insert key references by using actions found in the contextual menu. I have another instance of the word perspective, and this time it's not already inside a term element, and I want to insert a reference to the same perspective's glossary entry. So, in this instance, I'll delete that word. This time I'm going to right-click that key in the Reusable Components view, and notice that there are several options that I can choose from. For my purposes, I'll select Insert as Key Ref. Notice that this option presents a submenu that lists all the elements that can be inserted at the current cursor position. I want it inserted inside the term element, so I'll scroll to More and select that element. Notice that this time Oxygen inserted the key reference inside the term element. Now I want to show you the Components tab. This tab displays all the topics from the root map that contain reusable components, and it provides ways to easily insert them as content references or content key references. To determine which topics will be displayed in this tab, the DITA Reusable Components view considers topic references that contain a processing role attribute set to resource only to be the candidates to contain reusable components. Furthermore, the reusable components inside these topics are collected from all elements that have an ID specified. These reusable components are displayed in the Components tab along with the ID of the container and the ID of the component, the specific name of the element that contains the reusable content, a short preview of the content, the name of the file where the component is stored. This tab includes a search field that allows you to filter the text content. Some filtering options. For example, I can choose to only show a certain type of element, or I can narrow down the list of files by using the target file field. To demonstrate how the search mechanism works, suppose that I have this section in our user guide where it describes how you can move editor tabs. I already have one method documented, but I need to add two more shortcut methods. I know that we have a reusable container topic where we've defined all of our shortcut keys, and I don't remember the specific name of the file, but I know that it has the word shortcuts in its name. So, in the target file field, I'll enter shortcuts. Notice that the list is now filtered to display only the files that have shortcuts in their name. Now I know that the two shortcuts contain the comma and period keys, and also that one of the modifier keys is Alt, but I can't remember the second modifier key. Since the search field allows you to use search patterns, I'll use one to help narrow down the targets. This did not narrow it down enough, since the string comma also matches command. So I'll refine my search pattern even more by using double quotes for the comma string. And I can refine it even more since I know that Alt is one of the modifier keys. This narrowed the targets down to exactly what I'm looking for. So now I'll show you several ways to insert the components in a topic as conrefs or conkeyrefs. In my case, I need to insert a new definition list item, and I'll insert the first shortcut just by clicking the insert link that appears when you hover over the component. Note that if the parent topic of the selected component has a key defined, by default it is inserted as a conkeyref. Otherwise, it is added as a conref. Now I'll insert this description by double-clicking the appropriate component. Then, I need another definition list entry. And this time, I'll use the contextual menu action to insert the component. Notice that I can choose whether to insert the component as a conref or as a conkeyref. Another way to insert a component is to drag it from the view and drop it at the proper location in the document. So, these are the basics for how you can use both tabs in the DITA Reusable Components view to easily insert references to reusable content. And this concludes our demonstration. Thanks for watching.